Hello students, this is Pat Thakkar. In our previous videos, in our previous week, we have solved numerical based on forced convection. From today's video, we are going to solve numerical which is based on free convection. The difference between forced convection and free convection is, in numerical, in forced convection, the value of velocity of the particular fluid is already mentioned in the question. So from that clue you can identify whether this question is from the forced convection or free convection. In a free convection, whatever motion of the fluid is due to the buoyancy effect or due to the temperature difference of the layer of the fluids. So the second thing which we need to learn is how to decide the characteristic length, or we can say that the characteristic dimension in the case of free convection. So for that we need to look at the empirical correlations for the average Nusselt number for the natural convection over the surfaces. Suppose in question we have geometry like plate which is in a vertical orientation. So for the vertical orientation, the characteristic dimension is going to be its height, or we can say that its length. In this figure you can see that the height is capital L. So whatever the heat transfer by convection is going to take place, the fluid is going to take heat from the surface of the plate, and after getting the heat from the surface of the plate, the fluid is going in upward direction. So the fluid is going to cover its height, its total, the height L. So for a vertical plate, the characteristic dimension would be its height, whatever it capital H or capital L. If our plate is horizontal and the heat is flowing from the upper surface, convection takes place from the upper surface as you can see in this figure. So, and the convection is by natural convection. So what happened? Whatever the layer of air, suppose there is a air is our fluid and this is our solid boundary, upper surface of this plate, the temperature of this upper surface is TS. So what will happen in natural convection? In case of upper surface, the first layer which is going to be in contact with the surface of the plate is going to take heat from the surface due to the temperature difference. As it receives heat from the surface, the temperature of that layer is going to be rise. So by increasing the temperature, the density of that layer is going to be decreased as compared to the adjacent upper layer. So that lower dense layer is going to be replaced by higher dense layer which is at upper side of that layer. So this type of convection currents are produced. But in case of lower surface, the surface plate, the surface of this plate is going to stop the convection, natural convection currents which is going to be upward direction. So for the horizontal plate, whether it is from upward surface or lower surface, the characteristic dimension is going to be its surface area divided by perimeter. So if in question the orientation of plate is horizontal, then characteristic length or characteristic dimension should be its surface area divided by its perimeter. Now if there is a geometry like vertical cylinder, then the same logic as in a vertical plate, the characteristic dimension, or we can say that the characteristic length, would be capital L, or its height, whether it is mentioned by capital H or capital L. If horizontal cylinder, then its characteristic dimension is going to be diameter. So this is the some geometry which is going to be used in a numerical of the free convection. Let's solve first numerical of the free convection. A hot plate of 400 mm cross 400 mm at 100 degree Celsius is exposed to air at 20 degree Celsius. Here this 20 degree Celsius is surrounding temperature which is denoted by T infinite. The surface temperature of the hot plate is 100 degree Celsius. So TS is 100 degree Celsius, T infinite 20 degree Celsius. The area is 400 cross 400 mm, so that 0.16 meter square. Calculate the heat loss from the both surfaces. For the first case, when the plate is kept vertical. Second case, when plate is kept horizontal. The kinematic viscosity, relation between Nusselt, Grashof and Prandtl. In a forced convection, there is a relation between Nusselt, Reynolds and Prandtl. In a free convection, there is a relation between Nusselt, Grashof and Prandtl. There is a difference in a forced and free convection. In forced convection, there is always a Reynolds number. In a free convection, instead of Reynolds, there is a Grashof number, which contains the equation for the Grashof number is beta g delta t into LC raised to 3 divided by kinematic viscosity raised to 2. So here beta g delta t is a physical factor, one physical unit, which shows the motion of the fluid in a free way, in a natural way. Beta is a coefficient of volumetric expansion, g is a gravitational force, and delta t is a temperature difference. So in a forced convection, we can easily find out velocity, which is due to the external arrangement like pump. So from that, we can easily calculate value of Reynolds. In a free convection, instead of Reynolds, there is a Grashof number. So to find out value of Grashof, we need value of beta, g and delta t. Beta is a coefficient of volumetric coefficient, which can be easily calculated by 1 upon Tm. Tm is a mean temperature. So here, our surface temperature is 100, surrounding temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. So mean temperature is Ts plus T infinite divided by 2. So that the 100 plus 20 divided by 2, so that the 60 degrees Celsius. So first step is to determine the mean temperature, which is 60 degrees Celsius plus 273 to convert into Kelvin, which is 333 Kelvin. So beta is 1 upon mean temperature. So that 3 into 10 is to minus 3 per Kelvin. Now we can easily calculate value of Grashof number, dimensionless number, which is beta g delta t LC cube divided by mu square. Putting value of beta g delta t, characteristic dimension 0.4, because in our first case we have assumed that our plate is kept vertical, so that its height is going to be our characteristic dimension or characteristic length, which is 0.4. Divided by kinematic viscosity, value of kinematic viscosity is given in equation 18.97 into 10 to minus 6 square. So by solving these values, we will get value of Grashof number as 4.18 into 10 to 8. Now by using this correlation of Nusselt, Grashof and Prandtl, the value of Prandtl is already mentioned in question. So we can easily calculate value of Nusselt by using this equation, which is 78.63. Now we know that we can write instead of Nusselt is equal to HLC by K, where LC is a characteristic length. In our case, our characteristic length is height of the plate when we put it as in a vertical orientation. So LC is 0.4. So in this equation, only H is unknown. So by solving this equation, we will get value of H as 5.5 watt per meter square Kelvin. So now we have value of H. So from the value of H, we can easily calculate heat transfer rate by using equation HA delta T. Now when the plate is kept horizontal, now in case of horizontal, as we have just discussed, in case of horizontal orientation, the value of characteristic length is going to be its cross-sectional area divided by its perimeter. So in our case, it is 0.4 cross 0.4 divided by 4 into 0.4, so that the 0.1 meter. Now when you put plate in a horizontal orientation, there is a convection from the upper surface as well as convection from the lower surface. So we have two relations. For upper surface, we have to use this relation of Nusselt, Grashof and Prandtl. For the lower surface, we have to use this correlation for the between the Nusselt, Grashof and Prandtl. So first calculating for the upper surface, 0.72 Grashof Prandtl raised to 0.25. Now again we have to calculate value of dimensionless number, Grashof number, beta g delta t LC raised to cube by nu square. We know all the values. So by putting value in this equation, we will get Grashof number as 6.5 into 10 raised to 6. Now value of Prandtl, we know mu Cp by K. We know value of, instead of mu, we can write density into kinematic viscosity. Cp specific heat and K is a conductivity. All the values are already given in question. So by putting the value, we will get Prandtl number as 0.724. By putting value of Prandtl and Grashof in this equation, we will get Nusselt is equal to 33.58. Now Nusselt is equal to HLC by K. So from this equation, we will get value of H is equal to 9.405 watt per meter square Kelvin. Now putting value of H in HA delta T, here A is a surface area, which is 0.4 cross 0.4. Delta T is a temperature difference, which is 100 minus 20. We will get heat transfer rate for the upper surface as 120.38 watt. Similar calculation is going to be for the lower surface. But for the lower surface, the correlation between Nusselt, Grashof and Prandtl is 0.35, Grashof into Prandtl raised to 0.25. So, for this correlation, the Nusselt would be 16.33. So, again, the value of H is going to be calculated by using HLC by K. The value of H for the lower side is 4.57 watt per meter square Kelvin. Again, using HA delta T, we will get value of Q is equal to 58.5 watt. So the total heat loss from the both side, from upper side as well as from lower side, is going to be 58.5 plus 120.38. So it is going to be 178.88 watt. So this is for the first part of the numerical of the free convection. In our upcoming videos, we are going to solve some more numerical which is based on free convection. That's it for today. Thank you so much.